We're back with Brenda Barnette. She's the general manager of Los Angeles Animal Services. I had a toy poodle who was beautiful and smart, racist, but beautiful and smart, and she's no longer with us. She was bred, but she wasn't colored properly, so they were giving her away. Breeding dogs, there is flotsam and jetsam involved, right? There are puppies in the litter that don't meet the standards of the American Kennel Club, right?
Well, probably. I mean, I've seen, you know, litters that were all really good and could be shown, and I've seen litters that weren't. I think what I would like to do is draw a difference between people who have a litter of puppies in their backyard and think they're going to sell them for $50 to $250 or $500 or even $1,000 and make some money, as opposed to people who are actually seriously competing with their animals. The people who are seriously competing probably are not making any money.
What happens if you're trying to find that perfect dog? You have to put some dogs up for adoption, right?
Well, yes.
So that's a problem, isn't it?
You know, well, it depends on whether or not you think that's the source of the problem of all the unwanted dogs. I think it's the backyard breeder, and I think it's the people who aren't trying to do anything serious with their dogs that's the problem. But, you know, it's a matter of opinion.
What is the difference between a puppy mill and a backyard breeder?
Good questions.
And somebody who is creating show dogs for the Westminster Dog Show?
Well, the show dog people have taken into consideration structure, health, and all those kinds of things. So, and that's a very small percentage of the animals. The puppy mills have dogs that are bred in large commercial, like farms, where they just mass produce animals strictly for the purpose of selling them. The other breeder is the backyard breeder, and those are the people that we have to stop here in Los Angeles. They're the people who have, you know, a litter of pit bulls, a litter of Rottweilers, a litter of German
Shepherds.
Well,
who's breeding the dogs that go to the Westminster Dog Show?
Those are typically, I mean, I talked to some people the other day who needed to license their dogs, and she has two show dogs that went to Westminster. I don't know if both of them went to Westminster, but one did. And I said, you know, we have a license law in Los Angeles. You have to get licenses. We had a very lovely conversation, and she's done that. She's since done that.
But
she has two show dogs that she's traveled around the country with.
But isn't that a backyard breeder? Isn't a backyard?
She didn't breed them. She's never bred them.
Where'd she get them?
She bought them from somebody who was breeding them.
The American Kennel Club, the AKC, authorizes the Westminster Dog Show, right?
I think, well, it's one of their shows, I guess. I'm not
sure. The governing body for these dog shows.
Yes.
These dogs are purebreds.
Yes.
Where do they come from?
Breeders who breed them.
And I would assume they would be backyard breeders. They wouldn't be puppy mills. They wouldn't be factory farms. They'd be somebody who is...
They're typically people who are very involved in a specific breed because they love it for some reason or the other. It's very different from somebody who just wants to have a litter in the backyard because they think they'll make money or because they want to see their children, they want their children to see birth and life and grow up with puppies.
I mean,
that's very different.
But were you a lobbyist for the American Kennel Club?
No, that's one of those little rumors that's out there.
Legislative liaison.
No, I was a member of the Seattle Kennel Club when I was up there. Unlike L.A., every area that I've lived, I've had a cooperative relationship with the Kennel Club, and often they make donations to us. We go to their events and set up and talk about shelters. When there's a dog show, they come to our little shelter events.
Paid by the American Kennel Club?
Absolutely.
You never
not.
Got any money from the American Kennel Club?
No, that's all baloney. I was, my job was the emails came to my email box, and I redistributed them to the Kennel Club members without any comment whatsoever. I never went to a meeting. I was never,
Do you approve of the American Kennel Club?
I have my criticisms of them. I think they make a lot of money by registering puppy mill dogs.
They make about $53 million a year, and 60% of their profits come from registering puppy mill dogs.
Yes.
The American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals finds the American Kennel Club to be reprehensible. I think they only have about 6 inspectors. American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals says that the American Kennel Club is responsible for genetically compromised dogs, often living in traumatic conditions. So do you think that the American Kennel Club is a force of good or a force of evil?
Well, I don't think it's all one or the other. I do think that...
Why not?
That,
in all seriousness, I mean, if
no,
you're...
No, well, let me answer the question.
Hang on, but if you're...
Well, I'm trying to answer your question.
But hang on. The idea that something can be a mixed bag, something is, in my mind, is either good or bad. If you're
Well, that's in your mind. You're just black or white. But I'm going to talk about the gray here.
But hold it.
Because if you're talking about
animals that are genetically modified.
Well, but see, you're assuming
living in traumatic conditions.
You're assuming that everything that's on that piece of paper is 100% true.
It was in the New York Times.
Great. Then they're an authority on everything, and they never make a mistake, and they never quote a source who's inaccurate.
Okay. But you know the article I'm talking about, right?
But let me answer the question. I think that the AKC makes—
The American Kennel Club.
Yes. They make a lot of their money by registering any kind of puppy, by puppy mills or whatever, with no regard. They just want that registration fee. For that, I think, hands down, they're not good. Do I think that some of their educational materials, some of their stuff on their website is good? Yes, I do.
Okay, but that's not a mixed bag. It is.
It's gray. You're black or white.
Well, yeah, because we're talking about animals that are being traumatized and
you're assuming that every animal is being traumatized and that the AKC, they don't foster that. Have you ever read their website to see how they talk about handling animals or how they talk about the different temperaments? I mean, I love the ASPCA. They're actually doing a great work here in L.A. to help both the city and the county, and I work very closely with them. I'm not familiar with that particular quote.
Well, according to the New York Times, AKC, American Kennel Club inspectors, will give the seal of approval to breeders, say they're in compliance, and then a year later, the Humane Society will come in and find that there are dogs who are dead, covered in feces, they have cancerous growths.
Now, are you talking about you were at the ASPCA before, and now you're on the Humane Society, which is it?
I'm talking about the Humane Society will come in and clean up after the government has raided a breeder who was approved by the American Kennel Club.
So I would have to know more information because I'm thinking those breeders are big commercial breeders and that you're not talking about breeders who show dogs, that you're talking about big commercial breeders.
Big commercial breeders who
who
are AKC, American Kennel Club registered, who've been inspected by the American Kennel Club, and the American Kennel Club says that they're okay, and then they're raided by either the government or the Humane Society, and they find these dogs are being traumatized.
Well,
so how is that a gray area?
That's not gray. You're talking about something totally different.
But that's the American Kennel Club.
Yes. You're talking about large commercial farms. And yes, if they're inspecting them and saying they're okay and they're not, that's a big problem.
But that's evil.
Okay.
Why isn't that evil? I mean,
I'm not saying that that is good. That's bad. I would agree with that.
But so how can you say that they're a mixed bag if they're
because there are some things that they do. Like for you, for example, I bet you have some little quirky things that are just hateful. And on the other hand, I bet basically you're a good guy.
But I've
you're
never
not black or white.
But I've never hit a dog. I've never hit my kids.
Great.
I mean, so in other words, let me say something. Hang on for one second.
It's not so cut and dry.
It is cut and dry. Absolutely. The American Kennel Club is putting their imprimatur on breeders who abuse animals.
Those are commercial kennels.
Right. But the American Kennel Club is saying, we've inspected this breeder and he's perfectly fine. And it turns out later that this—
That's a bad
excuse
thing.
Me for one second. Excuse me. Let me finish my sentence.
Well, you don't let me finish.
Okay. but because this is kind of important, the American Kennel Club is saying, we've sent out our inspectors. This breeder is doing a good job. Let me finish. These dogs are perfectly safe. And then a year later, the government comes in, or the Humane Society comes in, and finds dogs living in feces. They have cancerous growths. They're being abused. That means that the American Kennel Club has sanctioned trauma for dogs. That is the worst thing you can do if your name is the American Kennel Club. If you're giving information on your website about how to hold a dog and how to train a dog, that is totally eclipsed by your sanctioning the abuse of animals.
Well, no one wants to sanction the abuse of animals.
So it's not a gray area, right?
That is not a gray area.
So they're bad. The American Kennel Club is a bad organization, right?
Well, I think they have some big weaknesses.
If they are putting their name...
If what you told me is true...
Well, it's in the New York Times.
Well, I would have to know more.
But we know that. Okay, so we do agree yeah. that if the... Good. So we agree that if the American Kennel Club has put its name...
We agree that if the people licensing commercial kennels are not really investigating and are not really upholding the highest humane standards...
We're talking about the American Kennel Club.
Yes.
Would you disassociate Los Angeles Animal Services from the American Kennel Club?
We don't have any association.
What about like dog shows that are governed by the American Kennel Club?
Well,
should they be banned in Los Angeles?
Well, I think they pretty much are.
Dog shows?
Yeah.
Why is that?
I think that the activists have made it so uncomfortable for them that they don't have dog shows here anymore.
And do you agree with that?
No, not necessarily. I don't think dog shows in and of themselves are bad. I think.
But we don't know where these dogs are coming from.
Well, I think you're being a little naive here. You don't understand the difference in commercial kennels and dogs that go to shows. They're totally different.
Are the commercial kennels sanctioned? The ones who go to shows are sanctioned by the AKC, right?
No, the commercial kennels are the ones who are supplying the puppy mills.
Okay, but who's supplying the dogs for the Westminster Dog Show?
Individual breeders.
And are they inspected by the AKC?
It depends on the size of their operation, I believe.
But I would assume they are being inspected by the AKC.
I think most of them are pretty small time.
Right, but we can't trust the AKC to tell us whether or not these dogs come from abusive conditions, right? Can we agree to that?
Yeah, but if they even inspect them. I don't know that they inspect every breeder.
So it's a nasty business, these dog shows.
Could be, okay.
Right? Isn't it?
You know,
honestly,
I think it's a waste of time for us to go down this path.
Why? Why is it a waste of time? Because you go to these dog shows.
Because I don't think you understand enough to have this conversation.
Okay, explain this to me then.
Because you don't understand the difference in commercial breeders who breed to put dogs out to puppy mills and somebody who is seriously, genuinely interested in the well-being of a particular breed because they love it.
And is the AKC, the governing body of these dog shows, do they care about the well-being of those breeds?
Probably not. They're probably big business.
Okay. So then shouldn't you distance yourself from the American Kennel Club?
Or fix it.
Well, are you fixing it?
No, it's not my job. I'm not working on it. I'm not heavily involved in purebred dogs or
anything.
But
shouldn't you distance yourself from these dog shows in the American Kennel Club? Do you think you should be breeding animals for show?
I am not breeding animals for show.
But you think it's okay?
I think the breeders that I know and respect, I don't have a problem with. The people who are commercial kennels or who are overbreeding, I have a problem with.
But you do have a problem with the American Kennel Club, right?
Yes.
And they're the governing body for these dog shows, right?
So what, I mean, is this a high school debate?
I'm asking you.
Why don't we talk about Los Angeles Animal Services?
Because you say that it's a gray area, and it's not. This is an evil organization.
Okay, so that's your opinion. Let's talk about—
Okay, but do you think—
Let's talk about how many fewer animals we're killing in L.A. city shelters. Let's talk about— You know, best friends and the sweetheart deal that people right. think that they have, which isn't
but,
true.
But, okay, but,
let's
but,
talk about my daughter working at Best Friends.
Let's
talk about some of the things that have been told, said that are untrue.
Okay, but I want to. But again, the American Kennel Club is an evil organization, and you did work for them.
I did not. I was a member of a kennel club.
And do you?
I did not work for them.
You are still insisting they're a mixed bag, and you're the head of Los Angeles Animal Services.
So what? I used to eat meat, and now I'm a vegan.
And, well, they are encouraging breeding of animals, right?
I think that is a I think these commercial kennels, if what you told me is true about their inspectors and the commercial kennels, then I think that's a travesty. The other things I don't think you know enough about to have an educated conversation.
Well,
and I'd be glad to take you to lunch and to try to explain a little bit more to you.
Okay.
But this is, you know, it's a waste of my time.
It's not a waste of your time, because the idea that we can't have an educated conversation implies that you have to be educated to know right from wrong.
So, no. It means that you don't know enough about what you're talking about to be asking me questions.
Right. Let me put it this way, and then I'll move on. We execute convicts who are innocent. Now, that's wrong, right?
Well, I don't believe in the death penalty.
Okay, but it is wrong to execute a convict who's innocent.
Yes.
Now, I cannot have an educated conversation about DNA or cruel and unusual punishment or how the lethal injection works. I'd have to spend 20 years in school learning all about that in order to have an educated conversation about that. But I know right from wrong, and if somebody's innocent, you don't execute them. I know right from wrong. The American Kennel Club gives their imprimatur to abusive breeders. Now, I don't need to be educated to know that that's morally reprehensible, right?
I agree that commercial breeding operations should not exist and that they shouldn't be sanctioned by any group.
And the American Kennel Club
evidently sanctions them, according to what you're telling me.
And so,
I mean, I, as far as I know, what they do is they make money by selling them litter registrations and registrations.
So that's evil. So they're an evil organization.
I don't think that that's,
that's an evil. That's evil. They're making money and turning a blind eye to the abuse of dogs. And then they wrap it nicely in a dog show with British accents and judges. That's
really,
evil.
The British accents, that's a new one.
But it's evil. It really is, because it distracts.
You think the British are evil?
No, I think that the Westminster Dog Show puts a shiny veneer on the overbreeding and abuse of dogs, and that's evil. And we know that's evil.
I think that the commercial breeding operations are definitely evil.
Okay, we have 1 minute before our next break. I didn't want to bring up your daughter because that's, the 11th commandment of everything. You don't go after the kids, but you want to bring it up.
Well, we may as well. I mean,
okay.
She was hired by Best Friends after.
We have a minute, so we'll take a break. We'll be back with Brenda Barnette. She's the General Manager of Los Angeles Animal Services.
This is the David Feldman Radio Network.